Homeless man finds out his shocking true identity after living for decades as a vagrant. Mick Myers had been homeless for many years, but it hadn't always been that way. As the years went by, the world forgot who he was. But after roaming around without an identity for so long, he ran into a cop who took Myers on an unimaginable journey to find himself. Like most homeless people, Mick Myers was often ignored as he roamed around the streets of Hayward in Alameda County, California. "Most of the people just hurry by and don't even give me a glance," Myers told KPIX5. But someone had noticed him, and it was too late to avoid him. Myers didn't have a lot on his schedule, so he spent most of his time panhandling near a freeway on Foothill Boulevard in Hayward. But he'd drawn some unwanted attention from the police. Myers had run into Alameda County Deputy Sheriff Jacob Swalwell numerous times before. The officer warned him about panhandling near the busy freeway, but he didn't listen, so Swalwell was forced to take action. For years, Swalwell had seen the homeless man begging drivers for money, and he was fed up with it. Now, most people would say that the officer was harassing this poor man, but Swalwell had a different objective. "It's a safety issue, and that was more of a concern than the panhandling," Swalwell told ABC7. He was ready to write Myers a ticket, but something the man said made him reconsider. "I asked him for his ID, and he said he didn't have an ID. And I immediately asked, 'Why don't you have an ID?'" Swalwell told KPIX5. And when Myers explained the situation, the officer's heart sank. "Got to know him pretty quickly and realized that a citation's not what this man needs," Swalwell told ABC7. But what was it that Myers needed? To figure that out, the officer had to know more about him. At the time, the 60-something-year-old man told Swalwell that before he was homeless, he used to work as a truck driver, but an accident had left him disabled. He spent a year in a wheelchair and another year in crutches. But when Myers got back on his feet, he encountered some difficult hurdles. He started working in manufacturing, but that didn't pan out. Then he tried working in the food industry, but lifting things and being on his feet all day led to excruciating pain. So he took his life in a dark and desperate direction. Unable to work, he started panhandling. "He does it 3 times a day, Swalwell told ABC7. "He's not panhandling for alcohol or drugs, he's panhandling to stay alive." But what did he use the money for? Myers walked around to the intersection's 4 lanes as the lights changed until he grabbed $5 or $10 from generous drivers. Then he walked to McDonald's or Wendy's to eat. But the officer was going to put a stop to this routine. "What's it going to take to get you off the street?" Swalwell asked, and Myers replied, "Well, a government check would do it, but I can't seem to get one." To get a check, he needed something he hadn't had in a while. Myers needed a state-issued ID to get the benefits. So Swalwell offered him a ride to the DMV. But the men encountered a major problem. "I'm no longer in the system," Myers said. "I don't exist anymore, according to the DMV. And he didn't have what he needed to get one either. Myers needed a birth certificate and proof of residency to get a California ID card. But he was adopted and never met his biological parents. So Swalwell had to reach out to the home of a higher power to prove his case. Swalwell got a letter from a church claiming that Myers resided in Hayward, California. But the mystery deepened when the officer acquired the homeless man's birth certificate from Highland Hospital, where Myers was born. He discovered that the name on his birth certificate was Gordon Michael Myers, but it took 3 trips to the DMV before he got his California senior citizen ID card. Myers held it up and took a selfie with Swalwell, which spread like wildfire on Facebook. "I walked into McDonald's to eat breakfast, and the guys I usually sit with go, 'Hey, you're famous, man,' and whipped out his phone, and there I am on his phone," Myers told ABC7. "But what about his social security check?" All the attention he got on Facebook led to a couple of job offers. Plus, he's now a step closer to acquiring his government benefits. In the process, Swalwell might have changed the way law enforcement treats homeless people. Sergeant Ray Kelly told ABC7, "I think we're going to bring it to all our trainings and say, 'Hey, if you have the ability to do something like this, let's go ahead and do it.'" Myers hopes other law enforcement officers will treat the homeless like a friend, the way Myers did. But luckily for Myers, The publicity was about to change his life once again. A private investigator of 25 years named Mark Askins had seen Meyer's story on KPIX5. He kept saying, "I'm lonely. I don't have anybody in my life," said Askins. So he volunteered to connect him with his loved ones. Meyer's adoptive mother was very nurturing, but he didn't get along with his adoptive siblings. So when she passed away, they cut him off and he became a loner. But Askins and a nonprofit group was about to change all that. Askins works as an investigator with Miracle Messages, a group that reconnects homeless people with loved ones. "There's always somebody in our lives who we think about as we fall asleep at night on our birthdays," said Askins. Could this great man help Meyer's find his real mother? Meyer's knew his biological family's name was Oakley and that his birth mother's real name was Marie. But could she be alive after all this time? He gave Askins permission to find out. And after some digging, he finally got a eureka moment. The investigator managed to locate his 85-year-old mother about 300 miles up north. As a child, Meyer's had a hole in his stomach, but his mother, Marie Pauline Oakley, couldn't pay for his medical needs. So her mother convinced her to give the boy up for adoption so he could get the surgery he needed. But when Askins reached out years later, it eventually led to the sweetest and most heartbreaking mother and son hug ever. Oakley and Meyer spoke on the phone first. "This is David Charles Oakley," Meyer said over the phone, and his mother cried out, "My son!" Eventually, he flew over to Humboldt County to meet his mother for the first time in 65 years. Not only had he found his mom, but also a whole family, which meant he was no longer alone. "Who'd have thought that something like this could have happened to anybody, let alone me," said Meyers.